Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on fault code P0128, as well as some symptoms, common causes, and fixes. So the description you'll get alongside fault code P0128 is coolant temperature below thermostat regulating temperature. And so essentially this diagnostic trouble code means that the engine is running cooler than it should be, or at least that the engine and computer think that it's running cooler than it should be. So a few of the most common causes for fault code P0128 are going to be a failing thermostat, the coolant temperature sensor, low engine coolant, as well as the cooling fan being stuck on. So a few of the most common causes there. Now, throughout the rest of this video, I'll go ahead and dive into each one of those issues that can cause fault code P0128, talk about some symptoms and things to be on the lookout for with each issue. So number one on the list here, jumping into thermostat failure as a common cause for fault code P0128. This is really going to be the single most common reason for this fault code. A thermostat, it's actually designed to fail in the open position. And essentially what happens when that thermostat fails in the open position, that allows maximum coolant flow through the radiator. Normally when the engine is cold or cooler, the thermostat would remain shut to prevent that coolant from running through the radiator. That allows the engine to warm up quickly and get up to operating temperature quickly. So when that thermostat remains fully open, that is going to provide maximum cooling and potentially not allow the engine to reach its operating temperature at all, which is in turn what triggers fault code P0128, again indicating that the coolant temperature is below the thermostat regulating temperature. A couple things to be on the lookout for if you suspect it may be a thermostat failure. Really the biggest symptom here is going to be this fault code and the fact that the engine is not making it up to operating temperature. So you might notice on your engine temperature or coolant gauge, if you have one, that it's not reaching the normal roughly 200 to 230 degree Fahrenheit mark, and it might be stuck at say 160, 170 degrees. That's going to be really the biggest symptom. And also on top of that, if the engine does actually make it to full operating temperature, you might notice that it's taking significantly longer to get there. Another common symptom with thermostat failure is that you might notice your interior or cabin heater is not working properly. Obviously, this is tough to tell in the middle of summer, or if you live in a warmer climate, you might not need the heater. And so this might be a symptom that goes totally unnoticed to you. However, if you are in a colder climate or using the car on a cooler day or cooler morning, you might notice if the engine coolant isn't making it up to temperature, that the heater in your vehicle actually isn't working properly. And that is because it does generate heat from the coolant and from the temperature in the coolant. So if it's not reaching optimal operating temperature, your cabin heater will not be working properly. It might get up to temperature. It might just take a lot longer than usual to get there. So a couple things to be on the lookout for. Again, thermostat failure is really going to be the single most common cause of P0128. This is almost always the issue at hand. Moving on to number two, we have the faulty coolant temperature sensor. So as the name suggests here, the coolant temperature sensor simply reads the temperature of the engine coolant. And so of course, if you have a faulty sensor there, it can throw all kinds of different readings out. It might be indicating that the car is running too cold when in fact it's actually at normal operating temperature, even running too hot or overheating. So a couple things there with the faulty coolant temperature sensor. Ultimately, this is something that certainly can cause fault code P0128. However, in most cases, issues with the coolant temperature sensor will trigger additional fault codes, P0116, P0117, P0118, and P0119 are all common fault codes associated with the coolant temperature sensor. Being a sensor, it is electrical, it has a number of circuits, and different things that will typically be triggered if the sensor is faulty. Things like it's not able to get a quality reading, or the reading is jumping around, and at that point the computer can pick up on the fact that it is the coolant temperature sensor that's having issues. So ultimately, if you just have fault code P0128, it's probably not an issue with the coolant temperature sensor, but if you do have these additional codes associated with it, then that could very likely be the issue that you do have going on with your vehicle. Moving on to common cause number three, We have the cooling fan stuck on. The cooling fan on a vehicle is really there for idling and low speed driving, especially on warmer and hotter days. The radiator does rely on incoming cool, fresh air. And so when you're up to speed, you have plenty of volume of air moving over the surface of the radiator. However, if you're idling or in stop and go traffic or at very low speeds, then of course you don't have that fresh air going over the radiator. And so that's where the cooling fan comes into play, as that will kick on and help pull that cooler, fresher air into the engine bay and over the surface of that radiator. Ultimately, if you're noticing this cooling fan is turning on and it seems like it's running excessively, then that could certainly be a cause of fault code P0128, as that may just be overcooling the engine bay, providing too much flow through the radiator and really just cooling the temperatures too much. Now, the thing is here, if the cooling fan is kicking on, that shouldn't matter. The thermostat should still be regulating the temperatures appropriately and closing and limiting the amount of coolant flowing through the radiator. If the engine is overcooling itself, this isn't a very common cause of fault code P0128, but it is worth the mention, since the cooling fans can be very noisy, it's something that can be easy to detect if that is your issue. Again, if you notice that cooling fan is kicking on consistently and constantly running, especially on cooler days or when the engine is cold, when the cooling fan really isn't needed and shouldn't be running, then that could be an issue that is causing and triggering fault code P0128. Moving on to number four on the list here, and last but not least, we have low engine coolant. This is pretty uncommon, just something that again is worth the mention since it's something that's very simple. And ultimately, what can happen with low coolant and why it can trigger fault code P0128. Sometimes you can get these air pockets trapped near the coolant temperature sensor, which can then cause it to not be able to properly read the coolant temperature, which will in turn trigger fault code P0128. If it believes that the coolant is under the normal operating temperature, not something that happens very frequently, just something to keep in mind. So with that said, circling back to fixing and diagnosing fault code P0128, a failing or faulty thermostat is really going to be the single most common cause of fault code P0128. In fact, that's almost always the case. It's pretty rare that it's any of these other issues that I discussed, especially if you don't have any additional fault codes, like for example, with the coolant temperature sensor, getting the codes like P0116 or something indicating there's an actual issue with the sensor, that can point you in the right direction. But if you really aren't getting any other fault codes, something pointing to say like the cooling fan or the coolant temperature sensor, anything else, then in most cases P0128 will indeed be the thermostat that is faulty or failing. So that's almost always going to be the fix for this fault code. Always start with the basics. Make sure that you do have the appropriate coolant levels in the vehicle, that there aren't any noticeable leaks or pressurization issues with the cooling system. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, everyone.